presenter, Danis.
Hello everybody, my name is Denis Kotkov. I am a PhD student at the University of Jyväskylä, and this research was conducted in collaboration with Drew Plans at the University of Minnesota. In this study, we summarized definitions of serendipity in recommender systems and showed that serendipity is valuable for users. First, I will give an introduction, tell what recommender systems are, what serendipity is, provide motivation for our research, describe our experiment, our results, give conclusion, and present our data set that we made publicly available for your use. Recommender systems are software tools that suggest items of use to users. For example, YouTube recommends videos to users based on videos this user previously watched. Recommendation algorithms that are part of this recommender system have traditionally been optimized for accuracy, which indicates how good we are at predicting relevant items that users like. As then we present the most accurate recommendations to users, they come back and complain. They say that the recommendations are not bad, they're just not right. They're too safe or too conservative. Another problem is that when we optimize for accuracy, we recommend items that users are already familiar with, or items that users would find easily themselves, they don't need a recommender system for that. Or items that users would consume anyway, regardless of whether we recommend them to the users or not. And we wanted to solve this problem. One of the solutions we found in literature was to suggest serendipitous items. And the first question we wanted to ask, what is serendipity? The first place we looked at was the dictionary. According to the dictionary, serendipity is the faculty of making fortunate discoveries by accident. We carefully looked at the description, at this definition, and tried to apply it in the context of recommender systems. So there are fortunate discoveries, which means an item has to be relevant to be serendipitous. They are discoveries, and discovery is a process of obtaining new knowledge, which means that the item has to be novel to the user when we recommend it to the user, to be serendipitous. And they are discoveries by accident. That means we should recommend an item that the user is not particularly looking for. But this definition is difficult to apply in the context of recommender systems. We don't know what the user is looking for, and sometimes the user would look for a good movie to watch. And then would we recommend a bad movie, but then it wouldn't be relevant to the user. And some terms, they have one definition in the dictionary and another definition in a particular domain. That's why we looked in publications dedicated to serendipity in recommender systems. And this is a definition of serendipity from one of those papers. First, the serendipitous items should be not yet discovered and not be expected by the user. Secondly, the item should be interesting, relevant, and useful to the user. According to this definition, a serendipitous item must be relevant, novel, and unexpected to the user. Here is another definition. Serendipity represents the unusualness or surprise of recommendations. According to this definition, an item doesn't have to be novel. It doesn't even have to be relevant, but unexpected to the user. We conducted literature review and compared many definitions of serendipity. And we found that there is no consensus on the definition of serendipity in recommender systems. But most authors indicate that serendipitous items must be relevant, novel, and unexpected. And there is no consensus on the definition of each of these components. So here I summarize what we found in the literature. The first, relevance. Relevance is simple. The user either likes an item or doesn't like an item. The user is either interested in the item or not interested in the item. With novelty is trickier. We found two variations of novelty. For example, we recommend an item to the user, and this is the first time in their life when they see this item. And we call this strict novelty. But it's also possible that we recommend an item to the user and the user has already heard about this item, but they just didn't think about this item at the moment when we recommended this item to the user. And then they consume the item because we recommended that to the user. And we call this motivational novelty. We found four variations of unexpectedness. Unexpectedness relevant is when the user doesn't expect to like an item. For example, I'm recommended a movie, I read the description, and I don't think I'm gonna like it. For example, I only watch comedies, and then I'm recommended a horror movie. That would be an unexpected recommendation for me. Unexpected as recommend is when the user doesn't expect an item to be recommended to them by a particular recommender system. For example, this is a recommender system that only suggests action movies, and suddenly some suggest a romance movie to me. I like romance movies, I just don't expect this recommendation from this particular recommender system. So we have one variation of relevance, two variations of novelty, and four variations of unexpectedness. And an item has to be relevant, novel, and unexpected to be serendipitous. So we ended up with eight variations of serendipity. They are based on the literature review. And the first question we wanted to ask, how are they different? And if we want to target just one of them, which one is the most valuable for users? Which one should we target? To answer this question, again, we looked in the literature review and we looked at why we should suggest serendipitous items according to the literature. And we found two reasons. First, because serendipity broadens user preferences. And second, because it increases user satisfaction. There was also a third one, which was overcoming the specialization problem, but that can be done through preference broadening. So we only focus on these two. But then we looked for the evidence for these benefits of serendipitous items. We wanted to look for the large-scale studies that would support these claims. And these claims are essential because the motivation of most papers on serendipity and recommender systems are based on these claims. And we found only one study. And the main takeaways there were that users prefer serendipity-oriented algorithms over accuracy-oriented ones, and that they give lower ratings to serendipitous items compared to relevant non-serendipitous ones. And the study was focused on the algorithm, so it didn't provide many details on the effect of serendipitous items that we were looking for. And the sample size of the study was relatively small. There were only 21 users. So we didn't find large-scale studies that would support these claims. That would support the claims that serendipitous items are any better than relevant non-serendipitous ones. So we wanted to ask the question, is serendipity valuable for users at all? Should we recommend serendipitous items? These were our research questions. First, we wanted to look at these building blocks of serendipity, that novelty and unexpectedness. What are the effects of variations of novelty and unexpectedness on preference broadening and user satisfaction? Then we looked at the variations of serendipity. What are the effects of serendipity variations on preference broadening and user satisfaction? We also looked at features important for detecting serendipitous items, and we assessed the number of serendipitous items in a recommender system. In this talk, I'm only going to cover the first two research questions because they have the most interesting results, and due to the limitation of time, please see the paper for more results. To answer our research questions, we conducted a survey in the movie recommender system, MovieLens, where users rate movies on a 5-star scale. They rate movies retrospectively, which means a user might watch a movie and then rate it a few months after that, or a year after that, or several years after that. First, we conducted a pilot study. We conducted a few pilot studies, and we found almost no serendipitous items in our data set. That's why we had this selection criteria for movies that we wanted to ask users about in our survey. First, we wanted to ask users about movies that these users recently watched. For example, they watched within the last 3 months, so that they still remember their experience. And second, we wanted to ask users about movies that were relevant to them, that these users rated with at least 8.5 stars. We selected relevant movies because we wanted to compare serendipitous movies with relevant non-serendipitous ones, and also we wanted to increase the number of serendipitous movies in our data set. And also, we selected unpopular movies because they were more likely to be novel to the users. And popularity here refers to the number of ratings in the MovieLens database. So our experiment started on the 1st of April 2017, and we selected all the users who rated at least 5 movies with the rating February and March. And we invited them to complete our survey. For our survey, for each user, we picked 5 movies that were the least popular that these users rated with at least 3.5 stars during these 3 months. This is what our survey page looked like, where we asked users to rate a number of statements regarding novelty, unexpectedness, and reference broadening user satisfaction. These were the actual statements that we asked users to rate. Users rated them on a scale, on the 5-value Likert scale, from strongly disagree to strongly agree. And so, for example, the first time I heard of this movie was when MovieLand suggested it to me. If the user agrees with the statement, we mark it novel. And the same applies to unexpectedness. If the movie was novel and unexpected at the same time, we marked it serendipitous, according to a particular variation of serendipity. Eventually, we received feedback from 500 users regarding more than 2,000 user movie pairs, and I'm just gonna call them movies for simplicity. So out of these more than 2,000 movies, 300 were serendipitous according to at least one variation of serendipity. The smallest category was 63 movies, and the widest category was almost 200 movies. So first we wanted to look at the effect of this building blocks of serendipity, novelty and unexpectedness. And for that we ran an ordinal regression model where our dependent variable was our metric and our independent variable was our component. And what does this table mean? So for example, this first cell means that we ran ordinal regression where our preference broadening was our dependent variable, and our independent variable was a binary variable, which was true when the movie was novel to the user and false otherwise. And this is a coefficient of this binary variable. So eventually we had 12 regression models, and these are coefficients of these binary variables. What we found? We found that all variations of novelty and unexpectedness have a positive effect on preference broadening. For example, when I see a recommendation of a movie and I see it for the first time in my life, then I watch it and I like it. This movie is more likely to broaden my preferences and make me interested in a wider selection of movies compared to the situation when I'm recommended a movie and I already heard about this movie and then I watch it and I like it. We also found one variation of unexpectedness which hurts user satisfaction, and this unexpectedness is relevant. Which means when I recommended a movie, I read a description, I watch a trailer, and I don't think I'm gonna like it. But then I watch it and I like it. This movie is less satisfying for me compared to the situation when I'm recommended a movie, I read a description, and I'm sure I'm gonna like the movie, and I watch it and I like it. We also compared different variations of novelty and unexpectedness between each other. For novelty, the results were not statistically significant, but for preference broadening, we found that unexpectedness fine and implicit outperform unexpectedness relevant. And for user satisfaction, again, for novelty, the results were not statistically significant, but for unexpectedness, we found similar results. Unexpectedness fine and implicit outperform unexpectedness relevant, and unexpectedness fine outperforms unexpectedness implicit. So, takeaways. If your goal is to improve preference, broadening, all variations of novelty and unexpectedness are good because they all broaden user preferences. Unexpectedness fine seems to be the best choice among variations that we found because it broadens user preferences and it outperforms some other variations of unexpectedness. Unexpectedness relevant seems to be the worst choice because it hurts user satisfaction, and it underperforms some other variations of unexpectedness. We conducted a similar analysis for different variations of serendipity, for user satisfaction, the results were not statistically significant, but for preference broadening, we found that serendipity generally have a positive effect on preference broadening, which means, for example, when I'm recommended a movie, and I find it novel and unexpected, then I watch it and then I like it, this movie is more likely to broaden my preferences compared to the situation when I recommended the movie and I don't find it novel and then I watch it and I like it. We compared different variations of serendipity between each other, and for preference broadening, the results were not statistically significant, but for user satisfaction, we found that motivational serendipity find outperforms strict serendipity implicit, which in turn outperforms motivational serendipity relevant. We also found that strict serendipity recommend outperforms motivational serendipity recommend. Conclusion. So we started this study when there were many researchers proposing different definitions of serendipity, looking at serendipity from different angles. And now we have a systematic study that summarizes different definitions of serendipity and assesses their value for users in terms of preference broadening and user satisfaction. And this is what we found. We can confirm the claim about preference broadening that yes, serendipitous items, they are more likely to broaden user preferences compared to relevant non-serendipitous ones. We cannot confirm the claim about user satisfaction because we didn't have enough statistical significance in our results. We also found that different variations of serendipity have a different effect on preference broadening user satisfaction, and so it's important to differentiate between them. And so which serendipity variation to choose? We found that according to our results, it seems that motivational serendipity find is the best choice. Because it outperforms some other variations of serendipity. And motivational and strict serendipity relevance seems to be the worst choice because they contain the component of unexpectedness which hurts user satisfaction. Again, because they underperform some other variations of serendipity. And finally, our data set. So the data set that we used for this study, we made it publicly available. And with this data set, you can conduct the same analysis we conducted in this paper, or you can also evaluate your algorithms offline. It has user answers to our survey questions, recommendations generated by Movie Lens for the users that took our survey. It has tag genome, the data about movies, and 10 million user ratings. The data set is currently available.